Hello and welcome to another quick edit video. This time I want to show you the editing workflow of this winter landscape image. Without further ado, here's the before and after image. So for this image there won't be much to do, but first let's activate the lens correction settings. The first thing I want to do is adjust the white balance to give my image a colder look, so I'm going for a colder temperature here. Also, I'm going to reduce the highlights quite a lot as the snow is really bright. Now with this I already got some details back from the snow. Then I also want to increase the shadows a tiny bit, and I also want to add some to the whites. Now I want this image to have a darker feeling to it, so I'm going to use a lot of local adjustments to darken it up. First I've applied two gradiated filters, one for the top. Here I just want to darken it, so I'm reducing the exposure a little bit. And also I'm going to reduce the whites quite a lot here. And you can see it already gets really dark. Now the second gradiated filter is just for the foreground, because I want to get a structure back in the snow. This works best using the clarity slider and also using the dehaze slider, but you got to be careful with this one. As you can see, the dehaze actually added some saturation to this area, so I'm also going to reduce the saturation here. And then I think I also add some whites to this place here. Then I also apply two radial filters. This one in the back is to add a little bit of glow. So for this one I'm adding a little bit of blacks, and I'm also adding some whites. The next radial filter is for the middle part of this image, and here I just want to add some more whites to the image. Okay, then there are a few more steps to take in Lightroom. First being reducing the saturation of the blue color tones. And then for the split toning, I'm not going to change the highlights here, but the shadows. And for those I want to apply a colder color, something around in this area, and reduce the strength of this effect. And like always, I'm adding a lot of sharpening to my image. And the last step is to add a slight vignetting. Okay, that's it for the Lightroom part, and I'm now going to export the image and finish it in Photoshop. Okay, first I want to get rid of those spots you can see in the foreground on the right side. Therefore I'm using the healing brush tool by pressing J, and then just brush over every single spot you can see there. I also might get rid of this wire. Again, I think I'm using the healing brush tool for this one. Okay, and now I want to add some glow to my image. Therefore, I'm using the Nick Collection plugin. And to add this glow, I'm using the classical soft focus filter. And here I just choose the second method of those presets and apply it to my image. I like how it looks, but I don't want the effect to be on the foreground in the right corner on the bottom, so I'm going to mask this area out by using a layer mask. And now I want to see if I can get some more details out of the foreground. Again, I'm going through the Nick Collection to see if I can find a fitting filter for that task. And I think for this purpose the best filter would be the detailed extractor, as you can see. Not only is it good for the foreground, but also for some of the areas on the left side, so I'm going to apply it as it is now. Now this filter really does a great job in my opinion, but I don't want the whole image to be affected. So first I want to apply a layer mask on this layer and fill this mask with a black color. And now I choose a white brush and just paint over the areas where I want the effect to be visible. Okay, actually I think this effect shouldn't be placed over the river, so I'm going to mask that one out again here. And that looks much better. And that's it for editing this image. I hope some of you found this video helpful, and if you'd like to see more content like this, then please feel free to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.